Kris Jenner, we're about to cook it up in the kitchen. She knows what she's doing, so tell me, what it smells so good already. What are we
making
here?
Isn't this good? Well, this is one of the first things that my kid's grandmother, Helen Kardashian, who they call Nana, taught me how to make. And it's an Armenian rice pilaf, and then they call it wedding pilaf if you add raisins and dates and nuts to it, which we do from time to time. But this was the first Armenian staple, like, dish that I learned how to make. And when I mastered this, I pretty much made it at least 3 times a week because it made me look and feel so good.
You have to learn a couple things that you can really rock.
So you take the egg noodles and you saute them in a little, I use rendered butter.
Right.
And you brown them. You add your white rice and then you can add the chicken broth to this. I bring it to a boil.
And this is low-sodium chicken broth as well,
right?
It is.
I use low-sodium. And you can make this ahead of time if you want to and keep the lid on. But I bring it to a boil, and then I'm going to swap it out here. Because once it's come to a boil, and then you let it simmer for about 30 minutes, and it becomes nice and fluffy.
Oh, yeah.
And with that, and see how the egg noodles cook down? And my granddaughter, North, this is her new favorite dish, and I must make this for her at least once or twice a week, and she just loves it and eats all the leftovers.
So I know at least twice a week I can come over your house and get the hookup.
If she doesn't eat it all. Yeah.
Just
you
make
need
extra.
To learn how to make
Auntie
this yourself.
Auntie Ma's coming over.
Yes, that's right. And then you toss in a little bit of
this.
That
looks beautiful.
And a little salt and pepper.
Why write a cookbook?
Huh?
Why'd you decide to write a cookbook?
Because I have had so many fabulous recipes like this in our family. And over the years, as my kids grew up, everybody had a favorite.
Right.
And so when they started going off to college, Courtney would call me at least 5 times a week going, can you tell me the chicken recipe one more time? Can you tell me Nana's pilaf one more time? So finally, you know, they have houses of their own this year, and I thought it would be a great thing to do and put all of these favorite, family favorite recipes, a compilation of all of them in one book so that they didn't have to call me, you know, all the time to repeat the recipe for the 300th time, but a book that would be around a lot longer than me.
That's funny. You can tell your kids, get the book.
Yeah, buy the book.
It's in the book. Buy the book. Now, this is normally a side dish. What do you normally serve this with?
Well, this is, we do it with lamb or chicken or beef or fish, but this, our traditional way of doing it around our house is with the shish kebab.
Keep talking.
Which we do. I know. Isn't it good? So we'll do a lamb shish kebab or a beef or a chicken and do the vegetables right on there so it's a complete meal and crusty bread. And
it just comes out looking like this.
Isn't that pretty? It looks
that
like...
is beautiful.
Like you feel like when I started cooking, I was 22 years old when I got married and I had started having babies right away. I got pregnant on my honeymoon and I was bringing all these babies home and somebody's got to feed them. They got to grow. You got to water them. And so I just learned how to make a lot of really family-friendly meals that were easy and didn't take a lot of time.
Right.
But that kind of made me look like a rock star when my friends came over. They would go, well, look at this. And I, you know, I love presentation.
Yes, and a beautiful presentation it is. I see we have some other things here.
Well, the brownies, this is the first, I went to cooking school when I was 22. That was the first thing I thought I would conquer is taking a class and learning how to cook stuff I didn't know how to do. And one of the first things on the menu was the brownies. And I've been making these religiously at least once a week for my entire life.
Wow.
And I give these, you know, if somebody invites me over for dinner, I'll bring brownies. So come on, I'm waiting for the invitation and I'll bring you some.
She's inviting me over for brownies.
Yeah, no, you're inviting me for dinner and I'm gonna bring the brownies.
I'm just supposed to let that hang in the air like that? I got a million jokes flying through my head about these brownies. No, seriously, once a week.
These are clean brownies, but we always have the.
We mean it.
Oh my God, she's a character. But it's just stuff that my kids are now used to because it becomes, when you cook something in your kitchen for somebody, it's a labor of love.
It's love.
And it becomes a tradition.
It does, and it's actually just nice to there's a difference between grabbing something to eat out and having something at home and smelling it being prepared. Like, I don't need an alarm clock. If somebody's cooking bacon in the kitchen, it was literally like, time to wake up. I mean, all my life.
Waffles,
bacon.
There's nothing
I could just
better.
Smell
I
it. So I totally understand that. And thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you
and
for
talking
having
with
me.
Us. And it's good to see you again.
Good to see you, too.
And thanks for leaving some food and some brownies here. You brought the good
I'm
stuff
taking
through
this.
Here.
We're taking this now.
me at the house for my brownies. Thank you so much, Kris. The book is called In the Kitchen with Kris. It's in stores now. Gorgeous presentations with all of these meals. So check it out.